YouTube, what is good, man? You know who it is. My kid back again. Y'all see the title, man. Timothy Bradley stops Brandon Rios. That's right. He stopped him in the 9th round. Bradley pretty much won every round in this fight with his new trainer, Teddy Atlas. Yo, the fight was a very exciting fight. Tim Bradley was smart with the movement. And at times, he really didn't move too much. It seemed like to me he didn't want to, you know, give Rios the edge. Obviously, you know, give him the edge, allowing him to come forward and get his shots off. So at times, Bradley was like, I'm going to just walk towards him and, you know, smother his punches and, you know, slip and, you know, land some, you know, shots of my own. So, yo, his new trainer, Teddy Ellis, is a good match. Not trying to say, you know, Joe Diaz wasn't a good match, but, you know, his new trainer, Teddy Ellis, he looked good, man. I mean, Tim Bradley was the only guy to ever stop Brandon Rios. Brandon Rios has never been stopped. I kind of think the fight was stopped prematurely, but I do think that Bradley was gonna beat him. I think Bradley was gonna beat him anyway, but I think the fight was kind of stopped prematurely. You know, I think he got hit with a body shot, and he just kind of, you know, went down on his knees, looking down to the floor like, you know, he was done. And then the ref said, you know, you look done, so I'm gonna help you out and just stop the fight. So, it's a very, very, very big win for Bradley. I'm pretty sure, you know, all the fans didn't count Bradley out. You know, some fans were rooting for him to get a 12-round unanimous decision. I thought Bradley was gonna get a decision, but he ended up, you know, stopping him with a knife. And Bradley, you know, kind of looked after the fight. You know, he kind of after the fight looked like, you know, hunching his shoulders, like, damn, I stopped him. He was kind of surprised, like, damn, like, I stopped him, and, you know, it was crazy, man. So Bradley looked good, and, you know, with the movement, his chin is still there. Like I said, a lot of fans were rooting for Bradley to win a decision. I thought Bradley was going to get a decision. He stopped him. And on the other hand, the fans on the other side, they thought, you know, Rios was going to, you know, stop Bradley, I don't know, in the 8th, 9th round. They were saying Bradley's showing signs of slippage, which he, you know, still is, but he ain't show no slippage in this fight. It was like Bradley's chin is not the same, and once he get hit by one of Rios' big punches, it's going to be over. And I'm pretty sure that's what a lot of fans were, you know, banking on for, you know, Rios to catch him with a shot and, you know, pretty much, you know, change the fight around, but that didn't happen. Bradley stuck to the game plan. He didn't stay in the center. Like I said, he was, you know, pivoting Brandon Rios, getting his shots off, not keeping his head in the middle. He throw, you know, lean to the right, throw right hook here, lean to left, throw left hook. Yo, he did everything pretty much good. He got hit, you know, with a few shots, but Bradley looked good, man. He looked good. Bradley still WBO welterweight champion, the belt Pacquiao used to own. Wow, this is crazy. So what's next for Bradley? Bradley can fight anybody he wants to fight, man. Oh, yeah. And actually, before the fight, during the undercard, what's this guy's name? I can't get his name, but Christina Poncha was with Bob Sheridan, and they were saying at the weigh-in yesterday that Tim Bradley looked drained, he looked dry, and I'm like, yo, why y'all jinxing this, man? He didn't look drained or dry tonight. He came in at 155. Brandon Rios came in at 170. Brandon Rios' last fight was at January this year. Tim Bradley's last fight was I can't remember when his last fight was, but Bradley looked good, man. So y'all just let me know what y'all thought of the fight, man, between Bradley and Rios, and holla at my mouth, all right?